Well, hello Malty Maple Syrups, Ralphie here. Now, it's getting a little bit chilly outside of the venue of the 5th Victoria Whisky Festival in Victoria, British Columbia, Canada. And I'm about to head inside where there's a pretty massive tasting session going on with over 160 malt whiskies from various destinations. Scotch, of course, Irish, Welsh, English, American and Canadian whiskies also present as well. So we're going to head on in, folks, and just see what's going on. This will incidentally be Whisky Review 104D. In we pop. Oh, fancy reception here. All very nice. And there's one of the organ. Hello there, Lawrence.
Hi, Ralphie.
Busy recording.
How are you?
I'm very... Would you like to welcome people, please?
Welcome to the 2010 Victoria Whisky Festival. The 5th Victoria Whisky Festival. And we have our new glass.
Yes.
With our new branding. Ooh. We change the branding every 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the first. This will be here in 2010 and 2011. And on the back, we have one of our sponsors, the Strath, which you visited a few days ago.
Did too and recorded.
And we're in the lobby of the beautiful Hotel Grand Pacific, who have really made this festival absolutely spectacular.
It is pretty spectacular. And I'll be having a wee interview later on, possibly tomorrow, with both Lawrence and Ian, the principal organisers of this event.
And Jonathan.
And Jonathan.
Dr. Jonathan.
Dr. Jonathan.
Right.
Excellent. So there's a doctor in case one of us kind of takes a bit of
right.
The worse.
Right.
Splendid. And I'm going to get on with my recording here, Lawrence. We'll see you
are
later.
Are you going to have a dram, Ralphie?
What do you reckon, viewers? Should I have a dram here or wait till I get home? You're going to twist my arm, aren't you?
I am.
It's that Canadian hospitality. It's much appreciated. So onwards and upwards. Thank you very much, Lawrence.
Thanks, Ralphie.
See you shortly. Now, but even before we go into the event where people are starting to get pretty busy with the samples, we're out in the lobby here and we've got some rather interesting maps, quite significant. I'm just going to take a wee wander through them before we pop into the hall, because they're quite revealing. Now, the first map here shows North America. Now, a few distilleries are, well, the distilleries are highlighted with the little red names and the little red Glencairn glasses. Some you're probably pretty familiar with, Jack Daniel, George Dickel, very traditional. And some probably not so, St. George, who produce some excellent whiskey, Anchor 2, and one that I've reviewed for you earlier was McCarthy's Single Malt. Now, we are up here, just under the Victoria Spirits, but as you can see, even moving across Canada, you're seeing starting to see distilleries where distilleries did not used to be. Interesting times. Things are getting a little bit crafty here, and I think we'll be seeing a few more of these, particularly these micro-distilleries, before too long. Again, the next map, moving along here, we have distilleries, locations around the world, some places like Russia, plenty of vodka from there. They do quite a lot of neutral spirits, but not what we would recognise as single malt whiskey. However, a few surprises in store. Here we are, Pakistan. Bet you didn't know that. Good old Scotland, England as well. Keeping busy. And here we are, United States and Canada, Brazil, Argentina, etc. And then we pop across again to a familiar territory. It is Scotland itself, and by far the busiest spot up here in Speyside region are approximately 84 distilleries, and down here in the borders, you're getting a few here, sunny little Bladnach, right down the south. Now this, ladies and gentlemen, is not, it says VIP, oh yes, whatever, but this is what I have to show to the gentleman at the door there before I can get access into the event. Let's see if it works. Good evening.
Hi.
Well,
perfect. This, thank you.
Thank you very much indeed.
Okay,
oh, we're in. Lead on. Very important for those attending a whisky festival. Plenty of water, got to drink plenty of water. Have a good meal before you arrive so as that you basically don't get too drunk too quick. In fact, don't get drunk at all. And some lovely ice sculpture here. Well, you certainly don't get this at the Scottish whisky shows. Hello there, ladies, gentlemen. And chocolates. I'll maybe see them later about that. And also for people attending the event, a quick whisk through.
Are you hard at it tonight, my friend?
I'm hard at it. What have you got in your hands?
I got
here?
A Belvoir. Very, very nice. It's nice and creamy. Yeah. So I think it's going to be a stellar one so far. It's very nice.
Excellent. You're being recorded, sir.
Well, I do watch you occasionally, if you're like this. Oh, well, yeah.
Well, that's much appreciated, you know, my friend. Thank you.
Thanks. The fine whiskey drinkers of the world.
Absolutely. Two is one each and every one of
you
us.
You got it, my friend. Enjoy.
And here there's being some food is being put on for the guests if they wish to have something. If not eaten before they came out, it's not a good idea to have a few whiskies in an empty stomach. So here's a place to come to get some hot or cold grub. So moving on, we know there's quite a number of exhibitors through this door here. And already the place getting a little bit noisier and getting busying up, and I know there's a few people here I'd like to have a word with, like with Andrew at the English Distillery Company and John Glazer at Compass Box, and hopefully some of the Canadian distilleries as well. What a racket. I hope this is going to be able to record okay. And of course, a bottle of water. Let's go for it, dudes.